required commitment, not a miracle. Erno loves you. Hi, assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh. Good morning everyone, welcome to my video. My name is Dhiya Vida Ramadanti. I'm college student at Biology Education Faculty Training and Education Sebelas Maret University. Today, I would like to share with you about type of acne and how to prevent them. My speech will be in 2 points. First of all, I will talk about type of acne, and second, we will look at how to prevent them. Let's get the ball rolling. Okay, main point one, type of acne. Let me start by giving you background information about acne. We may hear the term breakout used to describe all forms of acne, but is it not always an accurate description? Not all types of acne spread across the skin. Clogged pores cause acne itself. This may attribute to excess production of oil or sebum, then bacteria, hormone, dead skin cell, and ingrown hairs. By identifying which are types of acne we are experienced is key to successful treatment. Acne may be classified to non-inflammatory acne and inflammatory acne based on Kearney 2019. As I said before, firstly I'm going to talk about non-inflammatory acne. Non-inflammatory acne includes blackhead and whitehead. These normally don't cause swelling. Let me give you a solution to solve this problem by using salicylic acid. Salicylic acid is often marketed for acne in general, but it usually works best on non-inflammatory acne. It naturally can exfoliate the skin and removing dead skin cell that can lead to blackhead and whitehead. Look for it in cleanser, toner, or moisturizer. Then I will talk about inflammatory acne. Includes pimple that are red and swollen are referred to as inflammatory acne. Although sebum and dead skin cell contribute to inflammatory acne, bacteria can also play a role in clogging up pores. Bacteria can cause an infection deep beneath our skin surface. For example, Propionibacterium acne, Staphylococcus aureus, and Staphylococcus epidermidis often infect the skin then cause pus. This may result in painful acne spots that are hard to get rid of. Product containing benzoyl peroxide may help reduce swelling and get rid of bacteria within the skin. This can also remove excess sebum. A doctor may prescribe either an oral or topical antibiotic along with benzoyl peroxide to treat your inflammatory acne. Topical retinoid, for example, in Vitagit, are also an important part of combating inflammatory papule and pustule. Papule, pustule, nodule, and cyst are type of inflammatory acne. Take a look at the picture to give you an illustration of the type of acne. So let's cover everything I want to say about type of acne. Now let's move to the second point about how to prevent acne. As you know, pimple, also called acne, occur when our skin's oil glands are overactive and pores become inflamed. Sometimes bacteria make pimple worse. Pimple can appear anywhere on our skin, but they most often occur on our face. Because Sebelas pimple are usually triggered by androgen hormone, and in some cases genetic. There is no surefire way to prevent them, but still there are many methods to reduce their severity and keep them in check. Here, 14 of them. 1. Properly wash our face. 2. Know our skin type. 3. Moisturize our skin. 4. Use over-the-counter acne treatment. 5. Stay hydrated. 6. Limit makeup and don't forget to remove our makeup before sleep. 7. Don't touch our face often. 8. Use sunscreen and limit sun exposure. 9. Don't be a pimple popper. 10. Try tea tree oil. 11. Use an antibiotic. Then apply French green clay mask. 13. Avoid certain food. Last, it is very, 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 very important. Reduce stress. Also, manage pimple by eating right, reduce stress, and not popping pimples might help contain them and reduce how long they stay around on our face. Well, that's about it for this part. We have covered 17 million Americans who have acne. Also, I have acne, making it one of the most common skin conditions among both children and adults. Everyone gets pimples now and then. Many things cause pimples, such as hormones, then diet, stress, and genetic. Sometimes medication may even trigger breakout. And then, at their base, pimples are annoying. At their worst, they may cause permanent scarring, serious anxiety, or depression. Prevention effort might help, but they are not foolproof. Whatever pimple prevention plan we choose, patience and consistency are key. A dab of benzoyl peroxide might shrink a single pimple overnight, but most treatment takes several weeks to produce results. If you have any question or comment, please write them down in column comment. Please be kind to our face because we wear it every day. Don't be lazy to double cleanse our face. Use toner, moisturizer, sunscreen, and don't forget to remove our makeup before going to bed. I'm not the perfect, but my skincare routine is, especially to prevent acne problems. That brings me to the end of my speech today. I've talked about type of acne and how to prevent them. So I hope that my speech today will help us. Then, as the quote in the beginning said, beautiful skin required commitment, not a miracle. So keep fighting, everyone. Thank you. Wassalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh.